Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hopkinton High School as we have some great softball action about to come your way between the Bellingham Blackhawks, who are 3-2 on the season, and the Hopkinton Hillers, who are 3-3 overall. Bellingham led by head coach Dennis Baker Sr., the Hopkinton Hillers led by head coach Kylie Murray in her first season at the helm for the Hillers, as we are just about set to go on a beautiful sunny afternoon. Temperatures in the high 50s, low 60s. Let's take a look at the Bellingham lineup as Matty Mantegani is set to come up to the plate, first batter of the day. And following Matty Mantegani, you'll have Katie Reed, who will bat second. She's the shortstop. Casey Baker, the catcher, batting third, no relation to the head coach Dennis Baker Sr. Kelly Corbett in the cleanup spot playing left field. Julia Cadell hitting fifth playing right field. Elena Chambers batting sixth playing first base. Caitlin Proffitt, the third baseman, batting seventh. Sarah Trudeau, the second baseman, batting eighth. Blake Silvestri, the designated player, batting ninth. The windup and the pitch. It's a little bunt, and it is in fair territory. Throw to first, not in time, and it actually fell out of the glove of Isabel Holden, so Matty Mantegani aboard to start things off here in the first. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call as we bring you Hopkinton Hillers softball here on HCAM television as Katie Reed steps to the plate to face Bree Mirabli. And this is a little chop shot up the middle. Mirabli to first, got her, and they did push the runner to second, so they got the job done. And Bellingham, tremendously known for manufacturing runs, as Mantegani moves up on the sacrifice. One away, Casey Baker will come up to the plate. Let's take a look at the Hillers field. Bree Mirabli is the pitcher, as Lee Curl is the catcher. At first base, Isabel Holden. Emily Whalen, the second baseman. Molly Bennett, the third baseman for the Hillers, as we get a timeout called by the umpire as they try to straighten something out. As the hitter steps in and awaits the pitch. Okay, the rest of the field in just a moment. First pitch is a strike. Shortstop is Kate Welzel for the Hopkinton Hillers. Welzel and Mirabli, the captains for Hopkinton, as that pitch just inside, 1-1. From left to right, it's Katie Holly, Lily Morningstar, and Lindsay Whittles for the Hillers. That pitch outside, 2-1. Hopkinton getting a nice win to start the week against Ashland. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike, 2-2. Bellingham, they came off a tough loss to Millis on Monday. The game went 11 innings, and the Blackhawks lost 9-8, a swinging strike, and there's the first strikeout of the day for Mirabli. Second out of the inning, Kelly Corbett to the plate, the cleanup hitter. A lot of great hitters on this Bellingham team. Is that pitch up high, 1-0. Matty Mantegani on second base. She singled to start the game and then was pushed up by a Katie Reed ground out. That pitch just high, 2-0. Bree Mirabli having a nice season from the mound for the Hillers. Swinging strike, 2-1. Mirabli in her 30 innings pitched has given up 7 runs, but only 2 of those runs have been earned. Swinging strike, 2-2. She has a .47 ERA in her 5 appearances. Swinging strike, there's another strikeout. And after a single, they go down 1-3, and we will head to the bottom of the first. It's a scoreless game here at Hopkinton High School. Bottom of the first inning, the Hopkinton Hillers coming up. Lily Morningstar to lead things off. She's the center fielder. The rest of the lineup, Isabel Holden batting second, the first baseman, Kate Welzel, the shortstop, batting third, Lindsay Whittles hitting cleanup, playing right field, Bree Mirabli, the pitcher, hitting fifth, as Brianna O'Leary set to deliver the first pitch for Bellingham. And the first pitch is going to be a breaking ball for a ball. Continuing with the lineup, hitting seventh, the designated player, Heather Hawley, left fielder, Katie Hawley, hitting eighth, and Emily Whalen, the second baseman, hitting ninth. That pitch outside, 2-0 to Lily Morningstar. Morningstar has played in four games, hitting a .333 overall, 3-for-9 at the plate. Has scored two runs and driven in one. That pitch up high, 3-0. We'll take a look at the Bellingham field. Brianna O'Leary on the mound, Casey Baker behind the plate. Elena Chambers over at first base, Sarah Trudeau at second. As that pitch is high, a four-pitch walk to Lily Morningstar to start things off for the Hillers first. At shortstop, Katie Reed. Third baseman is Caitlin Proffitt for Bellingham. Left to right, Kelly Corbett, Maddie Mantegani, and Julia Cadell. As O'Leary delivers, and that pitch up high, runner leading off of first, got a look from the catcher, Casey Baker. Brianna O'Leary awaits the sign. And that is a ball, struggling a little bit early on. And Bellingham has been playing a lot of road games. They actually have not had a home game yet this season. One of their scheduled home games, as there's a swinging strike, was pushed to a road game due to field conditions. So they have played five away games to start the season. But that will be a little bit favorable towards the end of the year, as there is a strike. 2-2 on Isabel Holden. As Brianna O'Leary will look in. As this is hit in the air to center field, and that is deep and will drop down for a base hit. And the run being waved around from third, the throw in is not going to be in time, and it is 1-0 Hillers. An RBI double for Isabel Holden. Drives in Lily Morningstar, and the Hillers strike first. And now Kate Welzel with a chance to continue the early game success. As she steps in, there's a strike. That is exactly how you want to get things started if you're the Hillers against this Bellingham squad. As this is towards third base side, it's fair territory right down the line, and it's going to be a base hit as it rolls into left field. A run scores, and Welzel is over at second base with an RBI double. 2-0 Hillers. And now Lindsay Whittles will come up to the plate. No outs in the inning still for the Hillers. And you got the cleanup hitter there. Well, Zell starting to hit the ball. Started off struggling a little bit, but last few games has been very successful as this is hit foul. That was Welzel's third double of the season, her fifth run batted in. Now Lindsay Whittles trying to continue the success. Whittles 2-for-16 on the season so far. Brianna O'Leary delivers, fouled away, 0-2. Bottom of the first, 2-0 Hillers, no outs. As Hopkinton gets the offense going early. O'Leary deals, just outside, runner will stay put at second, was taking a big lead. Hillers head coach Kylie Murray, assisted by Bruce Elliott. Bellingham head coach Dennis Baker, assisted by Kevin Ranieri, as Whittles is going to take that pitch off her leg, taking one for the team there, and she will get a free pass to first base. Two on, no outs, Bree Mirabli to the plate. And Bree Mirabli at a 133 mark to start off the year. That pitch just high. And perhaps a great opportunity here to really get the offense going for Mirabli. O'Leary deals just high, 2-0. On deck is Molly Bennett. Wide up and the pitch is just inside, 3-0. Whittles at first base, Welzel at second, two runs already in, no outs in the bottom of the first for the Hillers. There's a strike. Three and one on Mirabli. O'Leary deals down low, and Mirabli gets a free pass over to first base. Base is juiced for the Hillers. Whittles pushes up to second, Welzel to third, and Molly Bennett with a great opportunity here. As Brianna O'Leary going to get a talking to from catcher Casey Baker. Dennis Baker staying on the sidelines, going to see if Brianna O'Leary could maybe try to get out of this. So Molly Bennett coming up to the plate. She's 1-for-13 on the year. And we are may have a pinch runner here for the Hillers, and we will. Caitlin Sylvester is going to pinch run for Bree Mirabli. So pinch runner for the Hillers. Of course, Mirabli will be back in the game to pitch. As Bennett will take a few practice swings while the umpire fixes his mask. O'Leary's set to deliver. There's a strike, 0-1. And you gotta think, for Bellingham's case, they just played an 11-inning game on Monday. So after that, you must be a little bit tired. There's a strike. And playing a couple days later, especially from a pitching standpoint, not the easiest thing in the world. Because despite a pitcher getting less tired than in baseball, those arms do get tired. Is that one up high, 1-2. So we'll see what the leash is here with Brianna O'Leary. O'Leary deals, that is just high. It'll bring the count to 2-2. O'Leary deals. On the ground, up the middle, fielded by and bobbled by the second baseman. Throw to first is good, but a run does score. So Molly Bennett gets the sacrifice, and it's 3-0 Hillers. Well, Zell comes around. Whittles up to third, Mirabli up to second, or excuse me, the pinch runner, Caitlin Sylvester up to second. So an RBI sacrifice ground out for Bennett. And now Heather Holly at the plate. That's fouled away, 0-1. That was a good piece of hitting there by Bennett. That's exactly what he wanted in that situation. O'Leary deals. That's in there for a strike, 0-2. Heather Holly has a, as she showed last year, has a good amount of power if she makes contact with the ball. O'Leary deals. That's fouled away. Count remains 0-2. Katie Holly due up on deck. Larry deals. Swinging strike. And that'll be it for Heather Holly, two away. So now Katie Holly will come up to the plate. Katie Holly, just a freshman, at a 214 mark on the season. And she's going to lay down the bunt, pull it back, and take a strike. Runners on second and third, two outs, three runs in for the Hillers, bottom of the first. O'Leary deals. This is hit in the air. That'll drop into right field. One run in a score, another run being waved around, and she will come in as well. A two-run base hit for Katie Holly, and it is 5-0 Hillers. And that was a great piece of hitting. Katie Holly at second, and I think the ball got lost out there in the outfield, so it ended up being a ground rule double. But that would still score both runs. So a two RBI double for Katie Holly has broken this game a little bit open here in the first inning as Emily Whalen at the plate. And there is a ball, 1-0. Emily Whalen, also a freshman, having a nice start with the bat, 3-12, 5-16. She scored a run as that pitch inside. She's hit for a double this season. Some great freshmen on this Hillers squad. As this is hit in the air, foul down the right side. 1-1. Due up on deck, Lily Morningstar, top of the order for the Hillers. Shall Emily Whalen reach? O'Leary gets the sign. As this is hit in the air, it is in foul territory, but caught by Elena Chambers, the first baseman, and that will do it. But the Hillers do end up batting around in the bottom of the first, and they put up five runs as we head to the top of the second. This is Hopkinton Hillers softball on HCAM. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Hopkinton Drug, located in this historic New England town since 1954. They're a multifaceted store dedicated to providing clients with an array of healthcare options. Hopkinton Drug, located at 52 Main Street. Top of the second, Hillers leading Bellingham 5-0. Bree Mirabli is set to deliver to Julia Cadell. As the first pitch is in there for a strike. Good bottom of the first for the Hillers. That's fouled away. Julia Cadell, Elena Chambers, and Caitlin Profit due up for Bellingham in the second inning. We'll recap the Hillers first as well. Started off with a walk to Lily Morningstar as that pitch is down low. And then Isabel Holden, an RBI double to drive in Morningstar. Well, Zell followed up with an RBI double drive in Holden. And then Lindsay Whittles was hit by a pitch. As this is hit in the air, it is in play, and the catcher will drop it. Battling the sun there was Azalee Curl and could not come up with it. So Bree Mirabli walked, and that would load up the bases. And then you had Molly Bennett with a sacrifice ground out. And then Heather Holly struck out, and then Katie Holly broke it open with a two RBI double. As there's a swinging strike, and out number one for the top of the second. Third strikeout of the game from Mirabli. Elena Chambers up to the plate. There's a strike. That's fouled away. To the set, swinging strike. And that will do it for Chambers. Two strikeouts to start the second. And now Caitlin Proffitt to the plate. That's fouled off the catcher, 0-1. To the set. There's a ball. 1-1. Caitlin Proffitt, one of the captains for Bellingham. One of three captains. As that pitch in there for a strike, 1-2. Some good movement on Rabley's pitches. And there's one with very good movement for strike three. She strikes out the side. 1-2-3 they go. Bottom of the second, Hiller's leading Bellingham 5-0 on HCAM. Bottom of the second inning, 5-0 Hillers. As we are set to go, Brianna O'Leary set to deliver to Lily Morningstar. The Hillers batted around last inning. First pitch in there from O'Leary. That one is up high. O'Leary with some early inning struggles, and that keeping in mind that Bellingham played 11 innings just this past Monday. And that pitch inside. The scoreboard not operating, but the count is 3-0, signals the umpire. Fouled away, 3-1. Lily Morningstar, Isabel Holden, Kate Wilzell do up this inning. O'Leary deals down low, and another leadoff walk, second walk of the game for Lily Morningstar. And now Isabel Holden will come up to the plate. Well, you wonder what the leash will be with O'Leary, especially trailing 5-0. The windup and the pitch to Holden is in there for a strike. Nice breaking pitch there. To the set. And the runner stealing second, and she is safe. The ball fell out of the glove of Sarah Trudeau over at second base. And Morningstar slid in safely. Great slide for the stolen bag. O'Leary set to deal. Swinging strike. It's pretty good velocity on that one. O'Leary deals, and this is a little pop-up shot in towards center field, but there to make the catch was the shortstop. Katie Reed reaching over to make that catch for the first out of the second. Runner still on second base. Kate Wilzell to the plate. Wilzell had an RBI doubler last time up as this one's third base side. Throw it up first is high, and that is going to get away, and the runner will come home to score. So Wilzell reaches on the errant throw, and Morningstar comes around to score the sixth Hillers run. And fortunately, our cameraman Bob Hamilton is okay on that one as it got the fence just in front of him, as Lindsay Whittles will come up to the plate. O'Leary is set to deal. That's fouled away, 0-1. Bree Mirabli due up on deck for the Hillers. As the lefty Whittle steps back in the box. Hit by a pitch, scored a run in the first inning. As this is hit in the air, foul. And out of play, 0-2. O'Leary awaits the sign and deals. Down low, and did that get a piece of her? Yes, it did. So the second time this game, Lindsay Whittles is hit by the pitch. That pushes Wilzell up to second. Two on, one out, Bree Mirabli to the plate. Brianna O'Leary just struggling out there. As that pitch up high, 1-0, runner taking off from second. Wilzell slides in safely with the stolen base. And Casey Baker looked like the catcher looked over, but then just threw it back to the pitcher and let her have the bag. I don't know if third baseman was ready for the throw, perhaps. That pitch up high, runner from first taking off, throw to second, and this time they got her. So caught stealing is Whittles. Second out of the inning. Good throw from behind home plate by Casey Baker. And Baker does have a good arm from behind home plate. One of the better catchers in the TVL. As that pitch down low. Brianna O'Leary set to deal. In there for a strike. 3-1. Runner still on third, Kate Wilzell. Two outs in the inning. Another run in for the Hillers. As this is on the ground, left side, throw to first in time. A 6-3 ground out for Mirabli, and that will retire the side on the bottom of the second. We will head to the third inning. The Hillers leading Bellingham 6-0 on HCAM. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Webster First Federal Credit Union, providing financial products with attentive customer service to the local families and businesses of Hopkinton. Visit them at WebsterFirst.com. Top of the third, Hillers leading Bellingham 6-0 as Sarah Trudeau steps into the plate. Mirabli deals. That pitch is just high, 1-0. Well, nice way to start this game for the Hillers as they try to get back above 500 at 3-3 on the season. That pitch down low, 2-0. Sarah Trudeau, Blake Silvestri, and Brianna O'Leary due up for Bellingham, the bottom of the order. That pitch just high. Mirabli struck out the side in the second inning. Five strikeouts in this game for Mirabli. And here she is going to have her first walk of the game as Trudeau gets the free pass. And that will bring up Blake Silvestri. Mirabli deals, there's a strike. And we're gonna get a timeout here. Perhaps a lineup or roster change as Coach Murray over there talking to the umpire. So it was a number change for Bellingham. As they're just straightening that out. Silvestri back in the batter's box. Mirabli set to deal. And we get another timeout call. Strike Straighten out the pitch count. 0-1 on Silvestri. That's fouled away, 0-2. Swinging strike, one down. Sixth strikeout of the game for Mirabli. And now stepping in, Maddie Mantegani, as they go to the top of the order. And she'll get the running start on that one and foul it away. As there's strike two. Mirabli set to deal. And this is a little pop up. Mirabli has it. Throw to first. Runner back safe. Nice job by Mirabli. Good awareness there. Getting it right to that first base bag. Two away. Katie Reed to the plate. Mirabli deals. Check swing. Did she hold? Yes. 1-0. There's a strike, 1-1. Two outs, runner on first for Bellingham. Swinging strike, and that'll make it 1-2. Swinging strike, and there's out number three, second strikeout of the inning for Mirabli, and that is her seventh of the game. We will head to the bottom of the third, the Hillers leading Bellingham 6-0. Bottom of the third inning, a 6-0 lead for the Hillers. Due up for Hopkinton is the 6, 7, and 8 hitters, Molly Bennett, Heather Hawley, and Katie Hawley. Face Brianna O'Leary still out there on the mound, and the Hillers going to try to get that offense going once again. That pitch up high. 1-0. O'Leary deals. That is fouled away. 1-1. For those of you just joining us, a lot of offensive excitement early on for the Hillers. In the first inning, they plated 5 runs. Second inning, they added another one and lead Bellingham 6-0. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call for what has been a nice start for the Hillers to this game. O'Leary deals. That one is just down low. The first inning, started off with some early struggles for O'Leary. As this pitch is going to be just low. Excuse me, looks like they called it a strike, 2-2. And Bellingham is just getting off an 11-inning game that they played on Monday. And a 9-8 loss to Millis. This is hit in the air to right field, and ranging under it to make the catch is the right fielder, Julia Cadell. Out number one for the Hillers, and now Heather Hawley to the plate. In that first inning, it was a leadoff walk to Lily Morningstar. RBI double by Isabel Holden. Kate Wilzell then had an RBI double and knock in Holden. As that pitch had a lot of break on it, but is low. Whittles was hit by a pitch to follow that. And then Mirabli walked. Sacrifice ground out by Bennett. And then a 2 RBI double by Katie Hawley. And those were the 5 runs the Hillers scored, as this is a liner right into center field. That'll drop in for a hit. Rolls all the way towards the fence, and she will hold up at first base. A single for Heather Hawley. And that will bring up Katie Holly. Katie Holly had a 2-RBI double her last time up in the first inning. As O'Leary will step in and deal inside. One and oh, the bunt pulled back, fouled away, 1-1. O'Leary deals. Just outside, 2-1. Larry delivers, on the ground, gets away from the catcher. Heather Holly will push up to second on the wild pitch. Now a runner on second with one out and a 3-1 count on Katie Holly. Larry delivers, fouled away. Lefty steps back in the box and awaits the decisive pitch. That is just high. Katie Holly draws the walk. 2-1, one out, Emily Whalen to the plate. Emily Whalen flew out her first time up in the first inning. Pulled back the bunt, but not in time, 0-1. Runners will stay put. They both thought about taking off. Emily Whalen, a freshman, was at a .312 batting average coming into this one. As this is first base side, that'll drop in for a base hit. And the runners are all gonna stay put. Throw to second, and they almost got Katie Holly sliding back to the bag, but she slides back safe. So a single for Whalen. That pushes Heather Holly to third, Katie Holly to second. Bases loaded, one out. And stepping in for the Hopkinton Hillers is Lily Morningstar. And she has batted in every inning so far in this game. She walked and scored a run in both the first and the second, and also has a stolen base, which came in the second inning as that's fouled away. 0-1. That was a good job by Coach Murray holding up the runner at third. Keep the bases loaded with one out. Why risk it at the plate? O'Leary set to deal, and that pitch is just inside. The 1-1 to Morningstar on the ground. 2-1. Larry deals. That is low. 3-1. Let's not forget, base is loaded. If she walks, a run scores. And the umpire straightening out the count once again. Larry deals. That is hit in foul territory out of play. 3-2. Larry deals up high, and the seventh hitter's run will come around as Morningstar gets her third walk of the game. Heather Hawley comes around to score. Katie Hawley to third. Emily Whalen to second. Can also credit Lily with the RBI there, as Isabel Holden will step in. 7-0 Hillers here in the bottom of the third. To the set. That is in there for strike one. Now this game's already pretty broken open, but Isabel Holden with a chance to really break it open here. Isabel is 1-for-2 so far this game as she takes a strike there. She had an RBI double in the first inning, which scored the first Hillers run of the game as Lily Morningstar came around. Kate Wilzell will get up to the plate next, unless, of course, Isabel Holden hits into a double play here. As this is caught at second base. Throw to first is not in time, but a great job by Sarah Trudeau immediately getting that ball to first. So that was a fly out to the second baseman. That'll make it two outs in the inning. Kate Wilzell at the plate. She's 1-for-2. She reached on an error in the second. As there's a strike. She had an RBI double in the first, which drove in the second Hillers run of the game as Isabel Holden came around. Brianna O'Leary set to deal. On the ground, third base side, foul. 0-2. O'Leary delivers. In the air towards left field, and it is caught by Kelly Corbett for the final out of the inning. So the Hillers lead them, leave the bases loaded, but they do end up with another run. It's 7-0 Hopkinton as we head to the fourth. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Weston Nurseries, located at 93 East Main Street. Visit their garden centers in Hopkinton or Chelmsford. Discover their limitless possibilities. You could visit them online at westonnurseries.com. Top of the fourth inning, a 7-0 lead for the Hillers. Bellingham has some work to do. Casey Baker steps in and takes strike one. The 3, 4, and 5 hitters due up for Bellingham, Casey Baker, Kelly Corbett, Julia Cadell. Mirabli deals, swinging strike. 0-2. To the set. Just outside. 1-2. That one low, 2-2. Mirabli deals, that is hit foul out of play. Cal remains 2-2. Strike three. That is the eighth strikeout of the game for Mirabli. Now Kelly Corbett will come up. There's strike one. Mirabli deals, strike two. Got her swinging there. Here we go. Bradley delivers. That is just low. One and two. Inside. As Corbett turns away. There's strike three. Unreal how she just moves those pitches by these hitters. And a good amount of velocity by Mirabli, but she has a lot of movement on her pitches, which really confuses batters, because that one's up high. Julia Cadell struck out her only time up in this game in the second inning. And that is going to go off the batter. So Cadell gets a free pass to first base. She took one off the calf there, and now Elena Chambers will come up. Chambers struck out her only time up in the second inning. Fouled away 0-1. Rabley deals. Ooh, that one went off the batter as well. Pretty hard shot there in the rib area. And Coach Murray is going to come out and have a chat with Mirabli. That's two straight hit batters. Caitlin Prophet due up next. And Mirabli does like to paint the corners at times. And perhaps paint them a little too much there. Two outs, two on for Bellingham. And it's been a good performance so far for Mirabli, to say the least, as she has accrued 9 strikeouts so far in this game. As she is set for the next hitter. Overall on the season, 53 strikeouts for Mirabli. Of course, through 6-plus games. Of course, this one in progress. Hiller's 3-3 overall. As we have an official's timeout in the game, and here we go. Fouled away, 0-1. Bradley deals, just outside, 1-1. To the set, swinging strike, 1-2. Outside, 2-2. We do have bullpen action for the Hillers in case Bradley struggles at all, as that one's fouled away. She hit two batters in this inning. Heather Holly getting loose just in case. Long week for the Hillers. They also have a game tomorrow at home against Dover Sherborne. It's 3 games in a week. That pitch outside. It's a full count now. Fouled away. Good battle here between Caitlin Prophet and Bree Mirabli. Mirabli deals. That's fouled away. Bradley Gravely to the set. This is hit in the air in foul territory out of play. Rabley deals. Fouled away. What a battle. The captain, Caitlin Prophet, and one of the Hillers captains, Bree Marabley. Two on, two outs. Count has been full for some time. This has been a nine-pitch at-bat. And this is hit in the air. It is towards center field, and it's dropped as Morningstar tries to battle the sun. One run is in for Bellingham. So an RBI single for Caitlin Prophet. Elena Chambers pushes up to third. Julia Cadell came around to score. And now Sarah Trudeau to the plate. Rabley deals. Swinging strike, 0-1. Well, it's been a pretty rare occurrence this season when you see Rabley giving up two straight walks and then a hit. That pitch down low. Or a run that was actually earned. Only two earned runs given up for Rabley this season. Swinging strike. That sun out there is powerful in center field and right field. Certainly tough to battle. Rabley delivers. This is a liner. That'll get into center field. Another Bellingham run in to score. Throw to third is not going to be in time. It pulled Molly Bennett off the bag. And that is going to be an RBI single for Trudeau. She pushed up to second after the run scored. Caitlin Prophet up to third. Chambers scores the Bellingham second run of the game. As Blake Silvestri steps in and takes a ball. So the Hillers led 7-0 heading into the fourth, but Bellingham starting to get the offense going, and this one is not over yet. That one's fouled away, 1-1. Still a runner on third, two outs in the inning. Second and third for Bellingham, and a good opportunity here for Silvestri to get him back in this game as there's a strike. Silvestri struck out her last time up in the third inning. That one up high. 2-2. There's strike three, and she gets out of it. Bellingham did put up two runs in the inning, but the Hillers still leading 7-2 as we head to the bottom of the fourth. Bottom of the fourth inning, a 7-2 Hillers lead over Bellingham. Lindsay Whittles, Bree Marabley, Molly Bennett do up. And we'll see if Marabley stays in the game. Bit of a struggle last inning, and Whittles took one off the foot there. Had to shake it off, but she gets the free pass to first base, and that's actually her second time being hit by a pitch in this game. Or no, third time. She was hit in the first inning and the second inning, and now in the fourth inning. So she took three for the team today. Also scored a run in the first inning. Scored on the sacrifice, or the two RBI double by Katie Holly, which made it 5-0 Hillers at that point. And that pitch up high to Marabley. Larry Deals up high. Two and O. Inside, 3-0. Larry Deals. There's a strike. 3-1. Molly Bennett due up next. Swinging strike. Full count. To the set. Fouled away. As this one's fouled away. O'Leary set to deal. That one's up high. Mirabli draws the walk. First and second. And now we're going to get a talk on the mound as head coach Dennis Baker going to walk out and have a discussion with Brianna O'Leary, who's struggling, and we could have a relief pitcher here. And it appears we will. So Brianna O'Leary is going to head over to the bench. We'll have a relief pitcher for Bellingham, and we'll get you up to date with who that is once we get back. You're watching Hopkinton Hillers softball on HCAM. Hillers leading Bellingham 7-2. New pitcher for the Bellingham Blackhawks, Sonia Nelson. As Brianna O'Leary had some struggles to begin this inning. And she was pulled from the game. 2-on for the Hillers. As Molly Bennett steps in. There's a strike. First hitter of the inning, Lindsay Whittles, was hit by a pitch. Bree Mirabli, the second hitter of the inning, walked. There is a pinch runner for Bree Mirabli. Caitlin Sylvester is the pinch runner. As there's a pitch inside. And typically for pitchers, you'll pinch run for them just to save them from any kind of injury running the base paths. Wind up in the pitch down low. 2-1 to Bennett. Well, sometimes you have those days. Tough day for Brianna O'Leary. As Nelson delivers, there's a strike, 2-2. O'Leary gave up 7 runs on 5 hits. Not all of those runs were earned. Right up and the pitch on the ground, up the middle, gloved and bobbled at short. Everyone's going to be safe, and the runners will hold up after advancing a base. So it'll be bases loaded, no outs for Heather Hawley as Molly Bennett reaches on the error. Heather Hawley, 1-for-2 this game, had a single and scored a run in the third, struck out in the first. Big opportunity here. Nelson delivers, that's fouled away, almost took out the Bellingham coaches. What a power, Hawley makes contact. Nelson set to deal. And this is going to take a hop on the infield dirt and then go into foul territory for the foul ball. Right up and the pitch, a little pop fly in the air towards the left side, and it was just out of the reach for Kelly Corbett, who came running in from left field. 0-2. So 6 of the 7 runs were earned runs from Brianna O'Leary. She's still on the hook for a couple of base runners. Right up and the pitch, on the ground, foul down the third base side. On the hook for 2 of the 3 runners on base right now, Whittles and Mirabli. Whittles at third, Mirabli at second. Well, Caitlin Sylvester, the pinch runner at second. Molly Bennett at first. Sonia Nelson delivers just high. Nelson deals. On the ground, third base side, foul. Good battle going on here between Holly and Nelson. That one is up high. Two and two. Nelson with the 2-2. And this is a pop fly just above the head of the shortstop. It'll drop down. A run will score. Throw to third. They did get the runner going to third. But a run does come around to score as Whittles comes around. And that looked like it was just out of the reach of everyone. One of those awkward fly balls that kind of just hung up there and floated around. So Sylvester was thrown out. That's the first out of the inning. Molly Bennett pushed up to second. Heather Holly on first. She had the RBI hit. Katie Holly now to the plate. She's hit a double and walked. Also had an RBI, a two RBI double in the first inning. So one for one today with the walk. Showing bunt, pulling back and down low. It's now an 8-2 lead for the Hillers. They've scored in every inning of the ball game. As this is a pop shot right to the first baseman and handled nicely by Chambers. Two outs in the inning, Emily Whalen coming up. Nelson delivers to Whalen, fouled away. 0-1. To the set, on the ground, left side, gloved at short, throw to first, and it is just in time. Good speed down the line by Whalen, but a good throw by Katie Reed for the 6-3 ground out, and that is the final out of the fourth inning. But the Hillers, they do add another run, and as we head to the top of the fifth, it is Hopkinton 8, Bellingham 2. You're watching softball on HCAM. Top half of the fifth inning, Bellingham coming up to the plate. As stepping in to hit is the leadoff hitter, Patty Mantegani, and it's right back to Mirabli. Throw to first, not a problem. One away. Hillers leading 8-2. Katie Reed now coming to the plate for Bellingham. And that first pitch outside, 1-0. There is a new pitcher warming up for Bellingham. Swinging strike. Well, Sonia Nelson did a pretty nice job getting out of that inning. Be surprising to see if they don't stick with her. There's a strike. But it could be a good time to give some different pitchers some new experience. Swinging strike. And there's strikeout number 10 for Mirabli. Excuse me, strikeout number 11 for Mirabli. As Casey Baker steps in. That first pitch is a ball. Here we go, Fabley to the set. Outside. Rabley deals. There's a strike. Two and one. Outside. There's a strike. Turned the hitter away, but painted the inside corner nicely. Casey Baker has struck out in her first two at-bats. As this one is popped up, fair foul territory. Looked like it was going to land to the left of the line, but just foul. Count remains full. Rabley deals, as this is hit in the air, foul territory, and it is caught by the catcher, Azalee Curl, for the third and final out of the top half of the fifth. As we head to the bottom of the inning, the Hillers leading Bellingham 8-2. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate your pest problem, eliminate your pest problem. You can find them online at WPCPest.com. Bottom of the fifth inning, as the Hillers will send up the top of their order, Lily Morningstar at the plate. And the first pitch is a ball. Morningstar has three walks in this game. Has scored two runs and walked in a run. So was credited with the RBI. But Sonia Nelson back out there in relief for another inning of work, as that pitch up high, 2-0. Lily Morningstar, Isabel Holden, Kate Wilzell do up for the Hillers. Nelson deals. And that is at the feet of Morningstar. That'll make the count 3-0. Nelson deals inside, and Lily Morningstar has walked all four times at bat. That'll bring up Isabel Holden. Lily Morningstar is really helping her on base percentage, that's for sure, as that pitch down low. It was a 400 coming into this game. She only walked one time, however, coming into this game. Nelson deals to Holden. That's up high and inside. 2-0. Bellingham did have someone getting loose. It was Carrie-Ann Fagan who might come in if Sonia Nelson keeps struggling. That pitch down low. Nelson came in relief in the fourth inning after the Hillers added their second base runner via a free pass. Lindsay Whittles led off the inning being hit by a pitch, and then Mirabli was walked, and now another walk as Isabel Holden draws the walk. That's two straight walks for Nelson. That'll bring up Kate Wilzell with a nice opportunity here. Bottom of the fifth inning, an 8-2 lead for the Hillers. Bellingham having some pitching issues today. Is that pitch up high? 1-0. Nelson deals, swinging strike. 1-1. That pitch down low, 2-1. To the set, swinging strike. 2-2 on Will Zell. She's 1-for-3. Doubled, scored a run, and had an RBI all in the first inning. Reached on an error in the second and stole a base. This is hit in the air, left side, out of play. Count remains 2-2. Due up on deck, Lindsay Whittles. And Whittles has been hit by a pitch in every at-bat this game, all three times. Swinging strike, and Wilzell goes down. I'll bring up Whittles. Whittles might need a couple ice packs after this game after getting hit by three pitches. As the lefty steps in. Nelson deals. There's a strike. 0-1. 2-1. One out for the Hillers. Nelson delivers. Swinging strike. 0-2. Nelson's starting to settle down, it looks like. Nelson deals. Swinging strike, two straight strikeouts. Now Bree Mirabli due up. We'll see if she comes to bat or we have a pinch hitter, and she will. Nelson delivers, and this is hit in the air towards left field. That'll drop in. One run in a score, and the lead runner will hold up at third. After Morningstar crosses the plate, an RBI single for Mirabli. And it is 9-2 Hillers. As they keep the at least one run in every inning trend going. And we'll have a pinch runner as Silvestri will come back into the game for Mirabli. Molly Bennett at the plate. And this one is foul. Bennett had an RBI sacrifice in the first. Flew out in the third, reached on an error in the fourth. That one down low. Nelson deals down low. Runners will stay put. Good cover up by Baker behind home plate. Nelson delivers. And this is a shot that'll drop in a right center. One run is in. And now the lead runner going to hold up at third as Molly Bennett advances to second on the throw in. It's an RBI single. Mirabli up to third. Isabel Holden comes around to score the 10th Hillers run of the game. Heather Hawley coming to the plate. Two outs in the inning. That one down low, 1-0. Nelson to the set. That's up high. Nelson deals, and this is up the middle on the ground. That'll get through, one run in. Second run being waved around, the throw home, not in time, and it is going to be 12-2, and the hitter, Heather Hawley, trying to go to second on the throw in and was called out as it was a good throw from Casey Baker to the second baseman, Sarah Trudeau, but she does get the two RBIs as Mirabli and Bennett both come around to score. And it is a 12-2 game as we head to the top of the sixth. The Hillers all over Bellingham on HCAM. Top half of the sixth inning, a 12-2 lead for the Hillers. As Kelly Corbett will come up to the plate for Bellingham. Mirabli back out there. Mirabli deals. There's a strike. 4, 5, and 6 hitters due up for Bellingham. Kelly Corbett, Julia Cadell, and Elena Chambers. There's a strike, 0-2. Mirabli deals inside. 1-2. Pitch on the ground, up the middle, gloved by the second baseman. Throw to first, not a problem. 4-3 goes Kelly Corbett. One away, Julia Cadell to the plate. Mirabli deals. There's a strike. Oh, and one. And that'll go off the back of Cadell. It's the third hit batter this game by Mirabli. Now Elena Chambers to the plate with one out and one on. Swinging strike. Chambers 0-1 was hit by a pitch and scored one of the two runs for Bellingham in the fourth inning. And one down low. Set to deliver. That's fouled away. One and two. There's strike three, two away. That will bring up Caitlin Profit. Fouled away, 0-1 into the backstop. Mirabli deals. There's strike two. 0-2. Strike three. And that will end the top half of the sixth inning with a 12-2 lead for the Hillers. And we will continue on, it looks like, here at Hopkinton High School. Bottom half of the sixth inning, the Hillers back up to the plate. Katie Hawley coming up to face Carrie Ann Fagan, who's out there to pitch now for Bellingham. Third pitcher of the game used by the Blackhawks. Sonia Nelson gave up 4 runs in the last inning on 3 hits, walked a pair. Did have 2 strikeouts in the inning. A We are set to go. As this is hit in the air, a pop fly right over to the shortstop, and it is handled for the first out. Good catch by Reed. It'll bring up Emily Whalen. Line up and the pitch, running start, pitch inside, 1-0. As this is hit in the air, pop fly, and handled once again by the shortstop. Two outs. Now Lily Morningstar to the plate. She has been up to bat four times and she has walked all four as she hits that one down the third baseline. 0-1. She's actually scored three runs this game as well. Set to deal is Fagan. Hit in the air towards center field and caught. That'll be the third and final out of the bottom of the sixth. To the top of the seventh we go. The Hillers up by 10 over Bellingham. Top half of the seventh inning. And in to close it out for the Hillers is Heather Hawley as this is hit in the air, first pitch, first out. And that is a good start to the seventh as Sarah Trudeau pops out. That'll bring up Blake Silvestri. As Hawley set to deliver. And this is a liner right to the second baseman. How about that? Two pitches, two outs. And now coming up to the plate is Maddie Montagani. First pitch, a ball. 1-for-3 in this game, had a single in the first. Heather Hawley, the designated player in on the pitcher's circle, as that pitch down low, 2-0. Bellingham down to their last out. Hawley deals. There's a strike, 2-1. Hawley delivers, just high. 3-1. Wide up and the pitch. That's up high. So a free pass to first base for Montagani. Now bring up Katie Reed. First pitch, a strike. Hawley set to deliver. On the ground, up the middle, glove by the second baseman, throw to first, and that is it. A 4-3 ground out by Katie Reed, and the Hopkinton Hillers will come up with the 12-2 victory over the Bellingham Blackhawks. Quite an impressive offensive display by the Hillers as they improve to 4-3 on the season. Bellingham falls to 3-3. Bree Mirabli had a nice outing on the mound today. She went six innings, giving up two runs, three hits, had 13 strikeouts, hit a couple batters, and walked one, but a good outing overall for Bree Mirabli, and a great offensive display for the Hopkinton Hillers as they come up with a much-needed win and get back above the 500 mark with a huge win over Bellingham. The final score, Hopkinton 12, Bellingham 2. The Hillers score 12 runs on just 9 hits and ended up committing no errors. Well, Bellingham, they had their fair share of pitching struggles, but they managed 2 runs on 3 hits and committed 2 errors. Tough loss for Bellingham, especially coming off a heartbreaking loss against Millis in 11 innings, but certainly a good amount of talent on that Blackhawks squad, so they should certainly be okay going forward. But as for the Hopkinton Hillers, they'll look forward as they get a big win here against Bellingham and starting to rack up the W's in the TVL. The final score for the final time, Hopkinton 12, Bellingham 2. We thank you for joining us for this broadcast of Hillers Softball. For Bob Hamilton, I'm Bob Hamilton on camera. I'm Tom Nappy. Have a great rest of your day, everybody, and thanks for watching HCAM.